Hallelujah. Praise the living Jesus. Our God is good. And all the time, our Lord is good. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood. Father, we thank you. There is power mighty in the blood. Power to turn things around, power to heal the sick, power of transformation, power of change, power of healing, power of deliverance, power of liberty, power of freedom, power of breakthrough, power of victory and testimony in your blood. In Jesus' name, I decree. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. The Lord is awesome. More grace to everyone that is connected here. In the process of time, 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 I will just be brief tonight. In the process of time, in the process of time, Judges chapter 11, Judges chapter 11, Judges chapter 11 is a popular scripture and a popular story of a young man that we know. Judges chapter 11, what did he say? He said, verse 4, let me just take from verse 4 now. Okay, let me start from verse 1, Judges chapter 11. If you have with your scripture, you can join me. I read, he said, Jephthah, a brave soldier from Gilead, was the son of a prostitute. His father, Gilead, had other sons by his wife. And when they grew up, they forced Jephthah to leave home. They said to him, "You will not inherit anything from our father. You are the son of another woman." Jephthah fled from his brothers and lived in the land of Tob. There he attracted a group of worthless men, and they went round with him. Verse 4, that is where I'm taking my message from tonight. He said, it was some time later that the Ammonites went to war against Israel. When this happened, the leaders of Gilead went to bring Jephthah back from the land of Tob. They said, "Come and lead us so that we can fight the Amorites." That is what where I'm stopping. Yes, God bless you. Thank you for connecting. Thank you for connecting. The grace of God in my life and ministry is going to speak to you tonight, and heaven will respond to you as you get connected, wherever you are connecting from, in the name of Jesus. I am speaking tonight briefly, just briefly, in the process of time, in the process of time. Now, this is a story of Jephthah. Who is Jephthah? The Bible said Jephthah is known as the son or the child of an harlot, born to Gilead. Now, time may not permit, I'm just giving you an intro for tonight. Just give you an intro. Now, in the process of time, now, Jephthah is a son of a prostitute, an harlot. And Gilead was the father of Jephthah. Now, the Bible said, and Gilead had other sons from his wife. Gilead had other sons from his wife. It means that Gilead was married, or Gilead is married, while he was going out to flex with prostitutes. Good. And peradventure, or precisely, Jephthah is Jephthah's mother, who is the harlot this time around, might be, or is not even might, Jephthah's mother, the harlot, is a woman whom Gilead had dealings with. He wanted to marry her by virtue of spiritual understanding. But what stopped that marriage is the prostitution, the garment of prostitute that she has worn upon herself, which has made men or people to know her as. They knew her as a prostitute. And that deprived Gilead from getting married to her. Now, Gilead got involved with her to the extent that it led to pregnancy, and he came forth with a son, and he was called Jephthah. Now, because Gilead cannot marry a prostitute, he took a son and got married to a woman, his own wife, who also had sons or children for him. But Jephthah is the first son. Praise the living Jesus. Jephthah is the first child. Now, the Bible said, he got unto a time. Jephthah began to grow with his brothers. He began to grow with his brothers, taking them as his brother. They were living together as one family, one blood. Jephthah saw them as one. Jephthah did not see them as sons of another woman, but he seen them as same father, same mother. Jephthah loved them with the love of a brother. They began to do things as a family, until it got onto a moment where things began to sit up, and the father began to have properties. The Bible said the sons, which is the brothers of Jephthah, called unto him and said unto him, you cannot inherit anything from our father's house. You cannot inherit anything from our father's house. Why? Because you are the son of an harlot. What an insult. What an insolent. You are the son of an harlot. You are the son of an harlot. And so because Jephthah was a son of an harlot, he was deprived of the benefit and rights that suit him, or the rights that belongs to him as the first son of the father. He is supposed to be the next heir to the throne of his father. He is meant to be the next father in the house. But because of that foundation that was built by his mother, it deprived him of his inheritance. Not just depriving him of his inheritance, it deprived him of his relationship with his home. The Bible said, and the brothers threw him out and said unto him, get out! Who are you? You are a son of a prostitute. You are a son of an harlot. He became a great insult. It became a great insult. It became a great disrespect and dishonor that a man of such magnitude, a man of such honor, is being trampled upon. If you read, he said, Jephthah, a brave soldier. Jephthah is an honorable. Jephthah is a man of honor. But his honor has been punctured by the foundation of his mother. And because of this foundation, it deprived him of not going far. And they chased him away from partaking from his father's inheritance. Praise the living Jesus. In the process of time, that is what I'm dealing with. I'll be dealing on this topic for the next 3 days. In the process of time. In the process of time. The Bible said they threw him off. Get out. They threw him out. He is the eldest. But the younger ones gathered themselves together and threw him out. Get out. You have no inheritance here. Nothing qualifies you to be a partaker of this blessing, of this inheritance. A man of honor, a man of vision, but your foundation has been tampered with. A man of grace and fire, but something has tampered with your life that has become a garment of filthiness, covering what God has already given to you as a glory. A garment of dirtiness the enemies have used as a stepping stone to present before you as an evidence to weigh you down. This is what always weighs down Jephthah. Anytime Jephthah is in good mood, the devil will come with that evidence. Who is your mother? Is your mother not a prostitute? He becomes weak. And that is why there are times in life as a minister, as children and sons, daughters of God, each time you are connected spiritually, the devil will just present before you an evidence to tell you the reason why your prayers is not going anywhere, to tell you the reason why you should stop deceiving yourself. Hear me? Any evidence that is being held by the enemies against you tonight, the mercy of God is speaking over your life in the name of Jesus. The Bible said, and Jephthah was a son of an harlot, because the mother is an harlot, and Gilead had something to do with an harlot years back, and it came forth into a child that brought Jephthah into the land of the living. And because the glory of Jephthah is not a respecter of foundation, I tell you, listen to me, let me repeat it again. Your destiny in life is not determined by the foundation or the background of your house. God is not concerned about the background that you come from. Rather, God is concerned about the gift of the destiny he has bestowed upon you. Every man born on planet Earth has a place to occupy. You have a place to occupy. You have a place to occupy. That you are born in that family where this is not working is not a yardstick for your laziness. It's not a yardstick for your complaint. But no, God brought you to that family for a purpose. Hallelujah. That some of you be asking, why am I in this family? Why God brought me for this side? Why am I coming from this car? This and that and that. Let me tell you, you were there because God knew that you need to be there to turn that family around. Jephthah came to the house of Gilead from a prostitute. And the Bible said, there come a time
that the brothers sat themselves together and said, the way we are looking at this guy, he is being honored and respected everywhere he goes. But there is something we can use against him, and that is his mother's foundation. And they called a meeting and said to him, Jephthah, you need to leave this place now. For you are a son of nobody. Your mother is out there prostituting, and you are a product of prostitute. Who knows if our father is even your own father? What an insult. That was why they said to him, you cannot inherit. You cannot inherit anything from our father because we are not sure of your DNA. We are not sure of whom your father is. If your mother is a prostitute, then there is a certain percent that we are not even sure of you being a blood to us, sharing a blood with us. Maybe your mother has been pregnant for another man before meeting our father. They began to tell him reasons why he cannot be a beneficiary, a benefactor, a next of kin to Gilead. And they threw him out. Jephthah was not worried. I love that faith. He said, I'm not worried. But one thing I know is my foundation cannot put me down. My background cannot lie my back on the ground. Where I'm coming from doesn't matter. Where I am heading to, what matters a lot to me. The beginning of a journey does not matter, but the end thereof matters a lot. How you start your life should not be the reason of your being down, but your focus should be where and how you should end your life. Jephthah said to himself, my mother may be an harlot. I am not an harlot. My mother may have made mistakes. I will not allow the mistake of my mother to take away my miracle. May your mistake from tonight never swallow your miracle. In the name of Jesus. I'm speaking on what I titled, in the process of time. In the process of time. It is not the day a child is born that a child begins to grow teeth. It takes process. Jephthah was thrown out to the land of Tob. The Bible said the land of Tob is the land of worthless people. People without focus. People without worth in life. The people surrounding Jephthah are people that have lost hope in life. They are people that does not know what tomorrow holds for them. They are people that reason one way. They are people that have nothing to write home about. Hopeless people. Worthless people. People without dreams and vision. People that you cannot share idea with. These are the people that surrounded Jephthah. People that were also thrown out just as the way Jephthah was thrown off. People that were not recognized in their family. People that were just in the street, hustling, looking for what to do to survive. These are the kind of people that were surrounding Jephthah. But the honor in the life of Jephthah never allowed Jephthah to forget his destination. Discover what God has placed in your hand. Discover what God has placed inside of you. Hear me. There's something inside of you that nations will look for. There's something inside of you that men will look for. There's something inside of you that people will come after. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible said Jephthah was thrown out to the land of Tob. And he was there with worthless people. People without reasoning.
People whose thinking is different from his own thinking. People whose life have been written off and concluded. People whose mission is life is how to feed their stomach once in a day. People who has no dream. People who has lost hope in life and living. These are the ones that were surrounding Jephthah. Hear me. The Bible said, in the process of time, in the process of time, there was a problem that Jephthah was the solution. God is processing a time that you shall be looked for as a solution to a problem. Hallelujah. They will look for you. No matter how many people that have cast you away, no matter the evidence that have been presented before them, before you, to see you as a non-entity, to write you off from the surface of the earth. Hear me, a solution is inside of you that you shall provide. In the name of Jesus. In the process of time, do not be weighed down by what is happening to you. Do not be weighed down by what you have been passed through. Do not be weighed down by the mess that is around you. Do not be weighed down by the challenges that is around you. Do not be weighed down by the foundation where you came from. Do not be weighed down by the mistake of your yesterday. But rather, God is working out a miracle inside your mistake. In the name of Jesus, the Bible said, in the process of time, there was a problem that needed a solution. In the process of time, there was a meeting that needed an agenda. In the process of time, they needed a suggestion and an opinion. In the process of time, they needed a word of a man known as honor. In the process of time, they needed to hear the voice of a wise man. In the process of time, God is processing you for a period. What you are passing through is not the end of your life. It is a process. Hear me, God is processing you. What you are going through now is a process. God is processing you for you to become that honor that God has bestowed upon you. For you to become the solution that has been placed in your life. The Bible said in the process of time, they began to look for Jephthah. It was the brothers of Jephthah that sent Jephthah away, but it was the community that came to look for Jephthah. Hear me? I am not consigned of what chased you away. I am consigned because nation is about to look for you. I am not consigned of how many people has connived against you. I am consigned because group of men and communities is going to come and seek for your help. In the name of Jesus, only the brothers of Jephthah chose Jephthah away. They said to him, get out, for you do not belong to this place. But when the process of time was complete, the community held a meeting, and the elders were sent to look for Jephthah. Men that matters is about to look for you. Men of honor is about to look for you. Dignitaries is about to look for you. Why? Because God is processing you in the process of time. In the process of time. In the process of time. It is just a matter of time. And hear me, the time is now. The time is now. The time is now. Marriages has not been faithful to you. Marriages has not been good on your side. It is the process. This is the time that you're about to enjoy the best marriage. Business has not been good on your side. It is the process. The process of time is now. You are about to be a chain of control. In the name of Jesus. Hear me, hear me, hear me. Examination has been failing you. It is the process of time. The best time is now. God is about to grant you your heart's desire. In the name of Jesus. Relationship has not been faithful unto you. It is the process. Your marriage is about to be announced. In the name of Jesus. Hear me, whatsoever that seems so rough in your life, it is the process. And that process has come to completion. God has completed the process.
in the name of Jesus. You are about to be announced. Man that matters is about to look for you. The elders came to look for Jephthah. Elders that matters. Not just ordinary elders, but elders that were sent by the community. Elders that were sent by the king of the land. They said unto them, there is only man that has a solution to our problem, and that man is Jephthah. Though the family has abandoned him, though the family have thrown him away, though the family have left him behind, though the family push him away, but with the community, we need to look for him. I don't care to know whether your family is rejecting you today. I don't care to know whether your family has abandoned you. I don't care to know whether your family does not call you for meetings. They may not call you because you don't have money. There is nothing around you that they need from you. But hear me, God is not after that. Man is about to look for you. Your family is about to come back and say, we are sorry. In the name of Jesus, the process of time, in the process of time, God is processing you for the future ahead. God is processing you for a greater miracle. God is processing you for a greater blessing. In the name of Jesus, Jephthah was being processed. Jephthah was being prepared. Jephthah was being prepared. In the process of time, God is not after where you are. Jephthah was where? In the land of the tomb, where worthless people are. But when the time came, they came to look for him where he was. Hear me, wherever you are, God is about to locate you. Your distance is not a barrier. God will locate you. Wherever the enemies have kept you, God is locating you. Whatever situation has made you to find yourself, you are in a place where you ought not to be, by virtue of your hierarchy, by virtue of your destiny, by virtue of the grace that you carry, by virtue of your vision, you are not supposed to be among these people. But hear me, it is the process. 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 God is processing you. Where you are may not be comfortable. Where you are may not be conducive. It is just a process. You are about to go to your place of honor. You are about to go to your place of honor. You are about to return back your seat of respect. Your seat of honor. Your seat of respect. God is releasing it back to you. In the name of Jesus, the process of time. In the process of time. In the process of time. Jephthah was being processed. Jephthah was being processed. Even the family said to him, get out. Who are you? You son of an harlot. Who does not know his father? You son of an harlot. Whose mother is out there prostituting? You son of an harlot. How are we sure our father is responsible for your pregnancy? The process of time. So many things have been spoken against you, to you, even in your face. They never hide it. They don't speak against Jephthah at his back. They came to him and confront him and said to him, you are a son of an harlot. You cannot inherit anything in our father's house. You cannot have any benefit of any kind because you are not qualified for it. Hear me? Men may disqualify you, but heaven has not disqualified you. I hear God saying it. Men has disqualified you, but tonight heaven is qualifying you. In the name of Jesus, any opportunity that men has disqualified you with, any calling that men has disqualified you, I see heaven qualifying you. I am not interested in what men has disqualified you. If heaven has qualified you, no man can disqualify you. When God opens a door, no man closes it. When God says yes, who is he born of a woman that can say no to you? Tonight, heaven is about to turn the words of men to be to your full favor. In the name of Jesus, the words of men is about to turn for your good. In the name of Jesus, anywhere men has pushed you to, anywhere situations have pushed you to, anywhere challenges have pushed you to, hear me loud and clear. It is the process of time. You are bouncing back. You are coming back. You are bouncing back. You are coming back. Jephthah came back in a big way. Jephthah came back in a big way. Jephthah came back as an honorable. Jephthah came back with entourage. Jephthah came back as a leader. Jephthah came back with a new position. You are coming back with a new fire. You are coming back with a new mantle. You are coming back with a new grace. You are coming back with a new power. You are coming back in a big way. You are coming back with a new entourage. God is restructuring your life. In the name of Jesus, the process of time in your life is complete. The time is complete. You are coming back. Restoration everywhere. Spiritual restoration. Physical restoration. Marital restoration. Moral restoration. Oh God, financial restoration. Material restoration. In the name of Jesus, God is releasing you to manifest that honor that you carry right from the day you were born. That glory that you carry, that men are stamped with because of your foundation. That power that you carry, that has been tampered with, that has been contaminated because of your foundation. God is restoring double of it in the name of Jesus. In the process of time. 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 Jephthah waited for the process. He never fight. He never enter physical combat. Get out. You cannot inherit of our father's property. For you are a son of an harlot. They might have deprived you of so many things with reasons. Good reasons. Genuine reasons. Genuine reasons that is even against you. They had genuine reasons to throw Jephthah away. But remember what the Bible said, that even the lawful captive shall be delivered. Even those that are in captive lawfully, the law has already held them. That evidence has held them. That as evidence has given reason why they must be in chains. And evidence has given reason why Jephthah must not inherit. Jephthah, the reason why you cannot have an inheritance here is because you are a son of an harlot. And it's against our tradition. It's against our foundation. It's against our right. It's against our law for you to be an inheritance because your mother is nowhere to be found. Your mother is in the street selling off herself. So, you have no reason of any kind to have an inheritance in this place. But if God can deliver the lawful captive, God is about to deliver you tonight. I'm going to end here. Just want to encourage you. The process of time. You might be in pain right now, but hear what God is saying. The process of time. You might have been rejected and dejected. The process of time. God is just processing you. Your ministry may be rising and falling. The process of time. God is processing you for that greater anointing and vision. God is processing you for that greater mantle. For that greater fire that you desire. For that prophetic oil that you have been crying unto God for. For that revelation of God's word that you need. The process of time. You have been processed. Disappointment has been calling on daily basis, on monthly basis, on yearly basis. There's no stable relationship. Process of time. That process is about to announce you. That process is about to change in your life. God is about to give you a new mantle, a new order. The process of time. Close your eyes wherever you are. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Jephthah passed through the process of time and he never gave up. Tonight I pray for you. The grace never to give up, let it come upon you. In the name of Jesus. As you follow me on this series, in the process of time, I decree over your life, whatsoever challenge that has pushed you out from your inheritance. Heaven begin to respond now in the name of Jesus. Any challenge, situation that has pushed you out to worthless being, that has reduced you to nothing, that has taken away your honor, your respect, and your glory. Tonight, I decree the process of time, heaven has completed it in your life. In the name of Jesus, the garment of restoration in ministry, restoration in business, restoration in marriage, restoration in finances. Tonight, I release that garment upon you in the name of Jesus. I decree every captivity that has used against you, every law that has been used against you to hold you in chains, in captivity, to hold you ransom in these altars of darkness, I decree today that the mercy of heaven is fetching you out. In the name of Jesus, whatsoever that has been an hindrance, a reason, an evidence that has been presented by the kingdom of darkness to weigh you down, that the more you have been struggling and suffering to retain your seat of honor and position, the more the enemies is toiling day and night, fighting to bring shame to you, disgrace and reproach unto you. Tonight, I release the divine hand of the Lord from above to stand up for you in the name of Jesus. And I put a mark of expiation to expire every hand of the enemies against your life. Let them come to an end. In the name of Jesus, by mercy I decree, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise up in darkness, tonight they are condemned. In the name of Jesus, anywhere they want to present your case tonight, with an evidence of your past errors, with an evidence of your foundation, anywhere they want to present your case tonight, with an evidence of your foundation, the reason why they need to hurt you, the reason why they need to cage you, the reason why they need to scatter your ministry, to scatter your vision, the reason why they need that to make you to cry and to tear and sorrow. Hear me. Whatsoever reason that will be presented in the kingdom of darkness tonight, is it the reason of the foundation you came from? Is it the reason of the mistake of your father? Is it the reason of the mistake of your mother? I care not to know, but I decree every foundation that want to stand as a yardstick, as an evidence against you tonight, I challenge that foundation. Let them be corrected now in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever powers of darkness, forces that flies by day, by night, by noon, tonight, oh God, I decree, Lord, they will not stand over these ones. In the name of Jesus, according to your word, you said, oh God, that when men sleep, that the evil one goes around to sow ties. Every seed, oh God, of discomfort, every seed, oh God, of reproach, every seed, Abba Father, that will be sown against this one, sir. Tonight, Abba Father, may that seed not germinate. In the name of Jesus, the Bible said, and they throw away Jephthah because he was a son of an harlot. Every reason why, oh God, shame is coming unto us. Every reason why the enemies is striking, tonight, let your mercy begin to speak for us. In the name of Jesus, I pray right now, oh God, that heaven rise up for the sake of this one. In the name of Jesus, because of their connection tonight, I decree, whatsoever reason, Abba Father, that is surrounding the situations of their life, Lord, today, let them be terminated, and let, oh God, a double honor be given unto them. In the name of Jesus, that after this series, Abba Father, there shall be a change, there shall be a testimony. As Jephthah was recognized, as Jephthah was honored, Lord, I decree, Lord, let your honor come upon this one. In the name of Jesus, the brothers of Jephthah threw Jephthah away. But when Jephthah was to return, elders came to look for him. Lord, I decree, the family of this first may have rejected him, but I decree, men of honor will come to look for them. In the name of Jesus, dignitaries will come to look for them. In the name of Jesus, men in authority will come after them. In the name of Jesus, I pray, oh God, whatsoever that has been a reason in their family, why they will not smile, why they will not have comfort, Lord, let that reason be terminated. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I bless your holy name. Tonight it is settled. Your fire has taken over. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name I have prayed. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Follow this series, In the Process of Time. It's a series that God has given to me for 3 days, In the Process of Time. In the Process of Time. In the Process of Time. There are so many mysteries and revelations that God wants to reveal unto you and I. In the process of time. So many things is not just happening ordinarily. It's just a process. 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 It's a process of time. Don't panic that men that supposed to be a helper to you are no more helping you. Men that supposed to be close to you are not getting far from you. Don't be discouraged. It is a process. It's just a process. It's a process of time. You have looked up to men for so long. You have looked up to people for so long. It's just a process. And they have abandoned you. People that you look up to, that you think with them around you, they need to wipe away that tears from your life. And yet, they are the one causing you pains and, you know, sorrow. It's just the process. Don't be discouraged. It's just the process of time. I want you to encourage yourself with this scripture that we just read tonight in Judges chapter 11. Even Jephthah found himself. The Bible said Jephthah was a man, an honorable, a man of honor, But because his mother was a prostitute, they rejected him, they threw him away. And where did he find himself? A man of honor, supposed to be in the midst of honorables. But he found himself in the midst of worthless men. Worthless men. Men without vision. Men that does not, that eat from the dust. Men that eat from the dustbin. That was where Jephthah found himself. An honorable found himself with people that is eating from the ground. Hear me, loud and clear. I am not concerned about where you are, where you came from. I am not concerned about the foundation. I don't know whether they know God. I don't know whether they serve God in that foundation. But do not allow that to put you down. You are a man of honor. You are a man of honor. You may carry grace, you carry fire, but yet you are not seeing the evidence. The time has come that God will turn that table around for your good. You have the power to deliver. You have the power of prayer. You pray time without number, but you are not seeing results. Hear me, do not give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up, because the time of God to restore you is now. Jephthah is a man, an honorable, a man of honor. Honorable, respected man. But look at him when he came to his family. The family rejected him. His younger brothers packaged him and threw him away, and he left the city. They pushed him away and he left the city. But when they wanted him back, elders does not just go on assignment. The king of the land summoned a cabinet meeting. The king summoned a meeting, and they said unto them, go and bring Jephthah for us. Listen to me. Listen, your family has rejected you. Listen, it is not your family that will come to look for you. Men that matters will come to look for you. Kings will come to look for you. Queens will come to look for you. That is what God is saying. It's just the process of time. In 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 the process of time. Judges chapter 11. Judges chapter 11, in the process of time. That is the story of Jephthah. In the process of time, what reason is presented before you? What reason are they giving? What reason? Is it because you are limping on one leg? Is that the reason why you cannot be given that position? Is it because you are having one eye? Is that the reason? Or because you can't see, or because you are blind, or you can't see far, listen to me, whatsoever reason that have been presented, why they should not give you that job, why they should not give you that visa, why they should not sign that contract for you, whatsoever reason that have been presented, listen to me, God is processing you for a better one. In the name of Jesus, that marriage, you have been crying for God for that marriage to stay, for that marriage to work. Yet, the more you invest into the marriage, the more you get issues, the more you plan, the more you fix a date, yet it does not hold. In the process of time, people are around you that are going about spoiling your name, spoiling your name, why the man should not marry you, or why you must not marry the woman. Hear me. God is about to disappoint them because the process of time has been completed. In the process of time, It has been completed. And the honor has come. Restoration has come. God has come. God is about to send his angels to pick you from the worthless bin where you have been gathered with, to pick you from the crowd that have been surrounding you. God is about to pick you and place upon you the crown. God bless you. Yes, you are welcome. Thank you for joining me. You are welcome. Yes, Judges chapter 11. That is where we took. It's a three-day series. Tonight is just an introduction. Tomorrow you'll get the full package. In the process of time. That is the series we are dealing with in the next 3 days. That is the series. And if you are connected to my ministry, House of Prayer Evangelical Mission, also follow the series. I have another series in House of Prayer. Yes, so don't miss any of this series. God is about to turn stories around. In the process of time, this is the series we are dealing with for the next 3 days. I'm just giving an introduction concerning Jephthah. Read the story of Jephthah. You will understand that everything is a process. Yes, everything is a process. God bless you. The Lord lift you. You will not be ashamed to your generation. You will not be ashamed to your ministry. You will not be ashamed to your family. Yes. Men will have turned their back on you, but God cannot turn his back on you. Those that you have been crying to for help, they are nowhere to be found. They are no more around you. Yes, do not be discouraged. It's just a process. God is processing you. You are about to arrive. If you can follow this series, you are about to arrive. Your arrival date has come. You will no more be jobless. Your arrival date has come. You have submitted so many applications, so many credentials. You have submitted as many as possible. Any advert of vacancy, your name is always there. Yes, there's no way. It is just the process. But hear me. You are about to be honored. The honor of Jephthah came in a big way. He never gave up. Jephthah did not go and quarrel the mother. They say, why are you an a prostitute? Why are you an harlot? Why? He didn't go, but rather the Bible said, even when he found himself with worthless men, he never allowed his vision to die. He never allowed his dream to die. Yes, he never allowed his thinking to change. He was still looking up to that calling as an honor. He was still looking up to that seat of honor. He said, one day I will sit in my place of honor. I cannot be defeated. You hear me? You cannot be defeated. Powers cannot defeat you. Nothing on earth will defeat you. Your foundation will not defeat you. Yes, where you are coming from will not defeat you. The village you came from will not defeat you. If the village you came from, people have been defeated in that village, because you are following this series, God will make you to be a victor in the name of Jesus. You will not be a victim to death in that village. The death that is killing people in that village, you shall overcome that death in the name of Jesus. The thing in that village that is swallowing people's success, it cannot swallow your success. It cannot swallow your marriage. Whatsoever in your foundation, in your family, that says that people does not last in marriage, It is not for you. If they succeeded in the life of others, they can't succeed in your own life. They cannot succeed. Every battle in your family, in your village, every battle in where you come from, in your background, in the lineage of your father or mother, Lord, whatsoever battle that is confronting this one, that is hearing the sound of my voice, anything confronting you from the village you come from, tonight, heaven is contending with them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I feel the awesome of prophecy. I just feel it. My son Talebo Zubrakateya. Liga ya talebregedo shuba lata zibredish. Someone you need a divine restoration, spiritual. I hear him loud and clear. He said you need a spiritual restoration. Spiritual restoration. Your dreams is no more forthcoming. Your visions has been closed. You are someone that see that dreams. Your dreams is no more forthcoming. Tonight, the process is over. The process is over. You're about to come forth. You're about to break forth. You are coming back to yourself. The honor that God has bestowed upon you is coming back to you. Yes. Ragadabala to supre keto shandelene zebra dadabalaba like let the libra dosh. Ayadabos, you that desire the spirit of tongues. Ah, pepuriata zubra yadesh. Ranatato zubran talebosukaya dalabala. I see a new tongue. I see a new tongue. A new tongue is coming upon someone. Alabalaba. Libre gedabos supaya talibre gerush. Fire of God is already in the house. Let that you will not go empty and dead tonight. Masupa shantali bragosh. Divine visitation in your dreams. Heaven will visit you. God Himself will visit you tonight. Alababa supra talaba. Lite te zugala da bragado shatale bregedos. Liga da balata balabredos. You will no more be an instrument in the hand of the enemies. You will not be a practical instrument in the hand of the enemies. Alababa libregedos. Any kingdom where they've kept you, masite te tu shitalaba, where they used to practice their wickedness, tonight, heaven is setting you free. In the name of Jesus, heaven is setting you free. Heaven is setting you free. You're about to be settled. God is about to settle you. God bless you. I love you. God loves you. I cover your sleep tonight with the blood of Jesus. Your going out, your coming in is covered with the blood of Jesus. Whatever you desire in life, heaven shall respond. Anytime you close your eyes to pray, I see heaven responding. In the name of Jesus. What stop others in your home will not stop you. What belongs to you will come to you in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever that has been collected from you, anything that has been denied you, that belongs to you, that has been denied you, God is collecting it and restoring it back to you in the name of Jesus. God bless you. You can call me. You can chat me up. In the next 1 hour, I'll be online. To receive your calls, to receive your prayer requests, you can drop them. We are praying for you, and heaven is responding to our prayers. Testimony is yours. And I pray for you that God will give you the reason to know Him well and better. The grace for the race will come upon you in the name of Jesus. That from today, whoever that sees your face will see God's grace, and you shall run the race to win the crown. Thank you, Holy Spirit. God bless you. I love you. God loves you more. God loves you more. God bless you.